Hey, what's up guys, it's Ronaldo here. So this video is going to focus on Barry Bateman. Now, Barry Bateman is a journalist for Eyewitness News in South Africa. And what happened on the 10th of September, there was a impromptu press conference by the EFF with regards to claims that the Hawks will be prosecuting Julius Malema for shooting a gun in a public space without a permit or a license. Now, what has happened is there was an impromptu press conference after the fact, and I will just show the interesting part of that video right now.
If that is an attack, take it. It is. It's an attack. Take it. For Winnie, I will do everything. I did that when she was alive, and I will do that even now. I wish I did that.
So the video footage is correct.
I wish I assaulted him. Now that is a real issue. I wish I did a real thing. Proper. I regret not doing it. I should have done it so that I deal with real stuff. Me, I'm not scared. But uniform or no uniform, Afrikaner or no Afrikaner, white or pink, I deal with you decisively. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, so as you can clearly see, Barry Bateman used that lovely P word at the end. Now, I'm pretty sure that if you have to ask 99% of South Africans what they thought after Julius Malema made those threats at the end, I believe that 99% of the population would say yes, he was in fact what Barry Bateman said at the end there. Here is the problem that we face in South Africa currently. After everything that has been said in that press conference right there, what isn't trending on social media is the fact that Julius Malema once again made threats towards 4 million people in South Africa. You know, the white people. And then using a derogatory term to refer to them as pinks. Right? That is not what the discussion is about in South Africa. And that is not what is trending on social media. What is trending on social media is the fact that a journalist referred to Julius Malema after the cameras were supposed to be switched off and after the press conference referred to him as a P, right? Nothing racist about that. You can call somebody a P irrespective of what race, color or creed they are. But that is the talking point in South Africa. But you see, that's the current South Africa we live in, where a black politician can say whatever he wants, making veiled threats and insults towards the white population of this country. And that is not the news. That is not anything that needs to be taken to the Human Rights Commission, because we all know how they respond. According to them, Julius Malema can do no wrong. They've clearly stated that there's two set of rules, one for white people and one for black people in South Africa. So that's not the talking point in South Africa. And it's really sad that we have somebody in Julius Malema that has shared personal information of journalists, that has called journalists Satan, that has said you're an arsehole and an agent. This is the same person that is now complaining about a journalist calling him the P word. And that just shows how thin-skinned Julius Malema is. He can easily dish it out without any concern whatsoever. But as soon as somebody turns around and calls him exactly what he is, then EFF and all their supporters lose their mind and they want EWN and Barry Bateman to apologize. Now here's the thing. EWN came out and said that they've taken Barry Bateman off air and they apologize for anything that Barry Bateman has said. Damn it, EWN, can you not grow a spine? Can you not defend your journalists against what was said by Julius Malema? Because as soon as Barry Bateman asked him the questions at the end there, you could see that Julius Malema was trying to intimidate Barry Bateman. But instead of backing your journalists and instead of standing up against the EFF and the bullshit that they say, what you do is you cower down and you apologize to the EFF and Julius Malema. Shame on you. And lastly, what is most concerning is that Barry Bateman said this in his private capacity. The interview ended. The press conference ended. He packed up his stuff and he's allowed as a private citizen to say exactly what he thinks of Julius Malema. The fact that Newsroom kept on rolling and he got caught on camera is neither here nor there. As a private citizen and not doing this in an interview and on behalf of EWN, he's entitled to call Julius Malema whatever he wants. So to end off this video, we're living in a South Africa where a politician can say whatever they want. They can make threats. They can say we're going to slit the throat of whiteness. We're going to drive people into the ocean. We're not calling for the slaughtering of white people, at least for now. And yes, it gets reported on, but there's no consequences to that. But God forbid a journalist calling out Julius Malema for exactly what he is, and then everybody loses their minds. So to end off this video, can I please ask that we all use the hashtag #HandsOffBarry and show our support. Even though we might not agree with everything Barry Bateman has said, it just shows that we are actually standing up for freedom of speech in South Africa. The fact that there's so many trolls on Twitter that's trying to make this trend and trying to get him fired just shows the double standards that are on social media, because the EFF guys that are complaining about him using the P word are the same ones that laugh and share when Julius Malema calls people the most outlandish things and make threats on their lives. But hey, that's a double standards in South Africa, and it's completely unacceptable and really unfortunate. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by clicking the join button below. Also, please be sure to drop a comment and let me know what you think about this incident, as well as smashing the like button. Let's see if we can get 1,522 likes on this video. And that would represent that we stand behind Barry Bateman. Also, please be sure to subscribe, and if you are subscribed, hit that bell icon so that you can be notified of my future uploads. And lastly, please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.